Okay, I've got some flaking paint up here, maybe from water damage, or might be calcimine underneath it's letting go. We're going to scrape that up and trowel the edges off. We'll give it a side skim over and make it smooth, ready for painting. Little bay window and big room, very nice cornice, rosette, Art Nouveau style. Very, very nice example of Art Nouveau cornice. Probably done 1925. Maybe see that ceiling's got ripples in it when they're doing the lath and plaster in later years, in the 20s. It was very thin, and sometimes they used hessian matting instead of a beef, the hair from cattle mixed in, and they put it on very, very thin. You get a ripple effect. Like on water, it's very, very hard to fix. If it's strong enough, you can float right over it. But otherwise, you pull it down and put some plasterboard up. And sort of got stick-on cornice up here. That's lath and plaster with a fibrous plaster cornice. It's just before the fibrous plaster era, where they started using fibrous plaster sheets as well. Interesting crossover years. Just got the lath and plaster, but they started making fibrous plaster corners, but they're not using fibrous plaster sheets as yet. And they started putting sheets up with strapping first. They didn't do the joints in the fibrous plaster, they put a strap up. Yes, interesting. Okay, first of all we're going to scrape this back off. Where it starts to become firm. It's starting to become firm there. Next we'll seal it. The edges up with a Bondcrete to bind it up, so when we put the wet plaster on it, it doesn't start to peel more. That's what we've got at the moment. So I've got this a bonding agent, water additive, masonry, Best Bond, Bondcrete, there's Grip Set, quite a few of them available. And I'll put a bit in there. This probably should be deleted about 50%, so I'll add some water to that. Okay, we'll just mix that in. Might make it just a touch thicker. Maybe about 30% water, but this one's about right. You want it too runny and you don't want it too bluggy. Maybe just like runny cream. That's not bad, I think. Right up. Thank you.
there's any calcium ion there too, but it'll help bind that up as well. And just go into the paint a little bit. Because if you don't use this, it can keep lifting and lifting when the moisture from the plaster goes near that wallpaper. Also, okay. That's pretty well done. Let's seal all that up and bound it up. There's a little one up here I didn't see before. So just scrape this one back to it and bind that. Just don't keep on going and going once you strike reasonably solid surface with the wallpaper, where it appears to be starting to stick quite well, then that's enough. Okay. Give that a seal up. Okay, I'm just going to seal this patch up that I did yesterday. Not quite dry, but we'll get a coat of sealer on it, so putting a coat of paint on it later. Pretty well sealed up now. So it'll save putting a seal on the paint. We've got to go straight on the top coat on the back. Cracking along here, a bit of paper. So what we'll do, we'll just open it up a bit and we'll fill it up. So lovely little corners. I'll make a gap to get the corner cement in there to hold it all together again. And a bit more paint work again. Don't be minor tweaking here really. About 1920s corners until after the plaster the ceiling. It's just going to change over from Latham plaster to fibrous plaster. We've got to use fibrous plaster corners, but I've still got the old fibrous plaster, but the old Latham plaster ceiling. So. Main thing is to open it up a bit so I can get in there and hold it. Got a key to go in there again, the corner cement. Don't really want to do it too hard to cause too much damage though. Just might have to. That's not too bad. I'll move along to up there. Okay, might give that a coat of bonding agent too, just to seal it up before we do it. Okay, the mix is starting to take up, so we're going to get up and just trail this up. What we've got to do, we've got to smooth that edge out there and there. You're not going to see it when it's painted. So we've got to float the middle, which is probably about 1 millimetre. You can just do the edges, but this will be getting it more flat. I've just loaded the trowel up again. I'll put some more on. So we're floating the whole area up there with a corner cement. I'll let that cake up a bit. Plaster or corner cement. Let's get up and do this a little bit. Okay, we'll put it on, I'll let it take up. Maybe give it a bit of a scrape down. I'll trail it up into shape now. We'll get up and put that bonkery on the corners now. We'll mix it a bit gluggy this time. That'll sit in there, it won't run everywhere. We'll just put some bonkery in there, or bonder, binding. That 12 foot high of the ceiling. Okay, that's pretty well right for filling up now. cool. Okay, the section on the ceiling is ready to go over again. Curl that into shape a bit. There's a crack here. I'll come back and give it a good scrape down soon. Just got a quick carry over. This little one. Little crack. A bit of surface. Some cracks, compression cracks, and some cracks are opening up cracks. There's two ways crack can form. Yeah, so get up and move that corner. Trying to squeeze it in there. Hold it all together. Scrape it off a bit. The end of the small toe.
Give it a brush.
Down there. Scrape it up a bit. Nearly there. I'll shape it up a bit more in a minute. Okay, I'll take a closer in a bit. Scrape back. Oh, it's almost ready for a final polish. Okay, I'll polish this up a bit now. We don't add any water to the final polish. And we best add water on the final polish. Curling up against the corners, up to the corner. Thank you. Okay, that's pretty close. Almost ready for the final polish there. Keep this out. Little fiddler. I'll get back to the corners again. This timing's important when you're trailing. You'll catch the mix at the right time. A little bit of a surface touch there to do. Okay. Probably got both ready for a final polish there. Okay, I'll get a bit more. That's okay, just finishing this corner off. Beautiful out in the back corners. Try and push them into the cracks. Goes a trowel. Okay. A bit of a brush up in the shape. Just brushing it like thick paint, but you'd probably, you do have to come back over it to shape it up more. Otherwise you'll get a brushed finished. Okay. Filling. Push it right in. It's a small tool I'm using. Plaster a small tool. And get a bit more. Just a bit of a brush before I get down. The shape. It's pretty close to done now. Those gaps fixed up, ready to be painted. A bit more of a touch up, that's pretty well done. A little bit more cracking on there, I'll do in a minute. Intersection with a cracking along here in the corners. Beautiful part of the event. Yeah, so let's give that a quick patch up. Get a lot of movement along the wall and the ceiling, probably while it's cracked there. Brush. Quite often the detail gets lost in the corners a bit, so you don't have to be too precise with everything. Not like a trailing a flat area, just shaping this little corner up here. Brush away from the excess, or well, I suppose it can be that way too, but alright. Flip the paper out a bit, that's pretty well wet. This section. Okay, we'll just give this a final polish where the flaking paint was. Put a bit of water onto it. Yeah. little one final. And the job's nearly done then. Okay. Water onto it. Always just really on the final polish.
The water.
You can weaken the mix down too much in the other case. And you can slow the setting time down too. Now, that's the job. I hope you liked it. And the flaking paint up there, and we've done the corner repairs up there.